And when the mind holds still, through all these disciplines and hard work that you put in, through many lives perhaps, the mind holds still for an instant. And during that instant, this thing that kind of made you feel strongly intertwined with your body and mind, those knots are broken. You are able to free yourself and see your experienced self as a spirit. All these ideas you heard about religion, God, eternal soul, become real for you. Then you talk of religion from experience, not from book learning. Then you become, you see, let me tell you the conclusion of yoga. He says at best, through this process, you lead a disciplined life. At worst, you lead a disciplined life. At best, if you succeed, you become the prophet of humanity. You become the prophet of mankind. Because you are talking of religion from experience. So the aim of yoga, however hard is the pathway, the destination is grand. It's giving the greatest prize human beings can have, their experience of their essential in the spirit. So this is the gem at the end of the journey. And suppose you fail, so what? We chase after worldly things and we fail anyway. Haven't we noticed? We all finish up, broken up, and shattered. So instead of doing that, you kind of hit yourself in this difficult brick wall, and so what? But at least you lead a disciplined life. So yoga is something to recommend, but not to enforce on anybody. It's something that must come naturally from you.